Hey guys, it's Dina, and we are coming to you live from our car in the occupied West Bank town of El Bira. And we had to seek refuge right now because clashes broke out between Israeli soldiers who were firing live ammunition as well as rubber-coated steel bullets against Palestinian protesters. Young men just up the street who were throwing stones as well as Molotov cocktails. So at the advice of everybody, we went into the car to seek refuge, and we definitely heard the live ammunition. I'm with my colleagues right now, and I'm going to switch the mic. I'm going to switch the camera to them. This is Shadi, and this is Daryl. And we were actually, and Hagar is right here. We were actually doing something new. We were filming virtual reality. Daryl's holding the rig right now. And we were trying to, because it was, you know, it was a, quite an action-packed scene. And we were going to give you, and we did a little bit, a 360, why don't you tell them what we're doing in the VR, Daryl?
Like how it works.
Basically, it is a system of GoPros that you stitch together after shooting, and it makes a 360 degree view that you can move around in post.
And tell them how this is, the casing is created, and then how many GoPros and stuff. And people like to touch stuff.
It was 3D printed by,
yeah. 3D printed.
By a guy we know named our colleague Osama Aitani in Doha.
Right. He 3D printed, very flimsy, broken like 15 pieces already. And it has 7 GoPros, but it has the capability of having, I think, 14?
Yeah.
And it's really difficult.
So Daryl was really keen on filming this, even though there were, like, you know, shots being fired. They were up about a couple blocks away. I'm gonna get out of the car for a second just to give them a lay of the land, because it sounds like it's kind of safe right now. So just to give you guys, to situate you in terms of where we are, it's raining, so I think it's cleared out a bit. As I mentioned earlier, we're in the West Bank town of El Bira. This is Friday after prayers. Up the street right here was where the Palestinian young men were protesting. As I mentioned, they were throwing stones as well as Molotov cocktails we saw. Down over there was more the center of the clashes, where Israeli soldiers were responding with live ammunition as well as tear gas and rubber-coated steel bullets. This is the West Bank town of El Bira, and nearby overlooking here, you can see if the fog isn't, oh man, the fog rolled in. This is an Israeli settlement. This is the close proximity that Palestinians live to Israeli settlements, which are here in violation of international law. That is the consensus of the international community, but Israel disputes that. This is the Israeli settlement of Psagot. That means Jewish Israelis live here. You can hear more. It's, I guess you could hear the firing. It hasn't stopped yet. I see all your messages, guys. Thank you for saying stay safe. We're pretty far away from where everything is happening right now. But that is the settlement, and that is why... Okay, we're back. And so, hello, jitu min al-muwajahat. I'm asking if they came from the clashes. ايش عم بصير فوق هلا؟
He's
saying so there's clashes up there and people throwing stones. Oh, شفتهم يعني طخوا رصاص حي. He says there was live ammunition. ايش كمان شفت؟
في واحد مصاب واخذوا على المستشفى.
Someone got about Palestinian. One Palestinian got hit and was taken to the hospital over there. Oh, قديش قراب الجنود؟ I'm asking how close are the Israeli soldiers.
حاليا انسحبوا على اراضيهم بس احنا حاليا بالارض تاعتنا.
He's saying they went back to where they're from, and sorry about the rain, guys. And هلا جيتوا من المواجهات؟ لا لا ليش خايفين؟ I want to ask them what were they doing and what were they fighting for. عشان عم نحكي مع مشاهدين امريكان ففسرهم ليش انتوا عم بتكافحوا؟ ليش ترموا حجار؟ Why are you throwing stones؟
لانه بيحتلوا ارضنا وعرضنا.
Because they said they're occupying our land.
ارضنا وعرضنا، هذول ناس كلاب. واحنا هاي ارضنا بدنا نرجعها خاوه.
He's saying they occupied our land and they you know they want to get it back is what he's saying basically.
صارت ارضنا بدنا نرجعها.
They want
والاقصى بتنزل الاقصى بتنزل
اقصانا.
They're saying the اقصى they want
الاقصى بتنزل بالاقصى
the اقصى in Jerusalem.
دائما بيقتحموا الاقصى واحنا بدنا نرجع الاقصى اول شيء.
He's saying they want الاقصى mosque to return to theirs of course.
الاقصى اقصانا.
طب ليش انت
فسرنا
ايش هي اهميه الاقصى بالنسبه لكم؟ What's the importance of الاقصى انا اسكن
هنا؟ كل شيء من المعبد تاعنا الصلاه المعبد
القبلتين
والقبلتين والحرمين الشريفين.
The mosque and the two mosques and the holy sites belong to the Palestinians.
مصر النبي هي النهايه هم احتلوها الكلاب.
And the Israelis occupied it, he said. The Israelis are occupying it. I'm giving a rough translation of what I'm hearing. I said, "Leish, why are you covering your face? Leish مغطي وجهك?"
عشان ما يعرفوناش.
He says because he doesn't want to be known. طب ايش بصير لو عرف لو
بيخدونا من الضار.
He said if they are identified, then the Israeli soldiers will come and basically get arrest them in their houses. وصارت معك قبل مرة؟
لا صارت ما صح.
It's happened to him where he has been he was imprisoned. He said for 2 years. سبب ايش كنت ترمي حشيش؟ Sorry guys, Shadi's giving me cues on what to do here.
He's saying
he was arrested. He was basically arrested from his home. He was imprisoned for 2 years. And in the prisons, they hit him. He said they broke him. They
We're
going to go back into the car. Fikrak Nibza is scaring us. Yeah, it sounds like it's getting closer. So I think it's... We're hearing it being fired even closer. So maybe we should go back into the car. This is a live or fire that sounds like it's getting closer. So we're going to get back into the car, guys. As you can see, trying to factor in our first. Where's Hana? She's coming in right now.
Okay. We're still live. We hear things fired, and we want to err on the side of caution. So we're back in the car. Do you want to tell us? Let me flip the camera.
Tell us what's going on. Sorry, can we wipe the lens? Can I use this? Yeah. Sorry, guys. Here we go. It's rain all over. We're trying to wipe the screen.
Okay, so the Salem, which is an Israeli NGO, just released this report saying that between the 1st of October and the 24th of October, 149 people were injured with live ammunition, only in the BCO, which is the Beit El process.
Okay. Do you want to go? Go ahead.
I will, but I need to share
a little bit. How often do situations like these happen, especially in the last couple of months of unrest? Hagar is a local. She is one of our colleagues. She lives inside Israel. She's an Israeli citizen, and she's on our team this week. And so she knows, she follows very closely what's happening on the ground. So just talk to us about the last couple of weeks of unrest.
So in the last couple of weeks, there have been protests in Beit El, which is next to the DCO checkpoint.
It is a settlement, and it's also the command of the Israeli army in the West Bank. So it's a hot spot for a lot of tensions.
So almost every day, there were protests there. And the army is using live ammunition as well as rubber-coated bullets.
Speak louder.
And rubber-coated bullets, for some reason, Israeli army considers it to be like legitimate non-lethal force, even though people are actually very severely injured because of that.
Uh-huh.
I know that in two separate incidents, in the DCO, two Palestinians lost one eye. What else can I tell you?
Do you want Daryl to drive?
I need to.
So I'm just trying to figure out what these guys are doing over here.
Okay, so I need to post this on the AJ Post page.
So you can't drive and post at the same time. Okay, so you're
shooting.
Yeah, no, you should not.
Okay,
guys, just stop. What's going on here? Hi, it's Dina. We're still in El Bira, in the occupied West Bank. It's a town that is right next to Ramallah, where we've been reporting from and staying. And there was just a lot of unrest right now between Israeli soldiers and Palestinian protesters who live here. Palestinian protesters were throwing rocks, as well as you saw Molotov cocktails, Shadi.
Is it confirmed? Yes, I did see young men that were running with what I recognize to you.
Sorry.
Oh, no, go ahead.
We saw it in their hands.
We didn't see anyone throw it.
So
what we saw, I would be very, very accurate.
Yeah, maybe not this way. This is getting closer to the clashes. Turn around.
Yeah, we know.
You're doing that on purpose.
So I'm going to be accurate about what we saw. So we saw young men who were running behind the building, and they had what, appears to be Molotovs, which is, so they had the Coke bottles filled with
what's going on over here? This is, I guess.
So if you,
I'm shooting. What?
You can see. So it's very far down the hill.
Very far. I think we shouldn't get close though.
Okay, you can turn up the street, but if you look straight ahead, so right here, Tina, if you can shoot for here.
I am.
You see some boys taking refuge.
Yeah.
They're pretty far down the hill from where we had seen the soldiers. If you see the ambulances, it's past that. So look at the ambulance lights straight ahead.
Okay.
There's a hill. And so when we were overlooking, do you see the press up in that building?
Yeah.
We're past that another 5 or 6 blocks.
Okay.
So it's down a hill. We're very far. What would be interesting possibly is to walk into that store and talk to those guys.
I just got a message. I just got a مرحبا كيفك تعال احكي معنا احكي شو عم بصير right now. I'm asking them. انت ساكنين هون قريب؟ They live right here. شو عم بصير هون? What's happening?
شو بكتي أني لو خيط أني عربني أني مش بحا.
Okay, he's speaking Hebrew. I'm sorry. ما بفهم عبراني أنا.
بس
انت شو يعني شو عم بصير هلا وانت حاضر؟
في ضرب جور.
They're throwing stones.
بس علينا. دخوا هاي علينا.
They're saying the Israeli soldiers are shooting live ammunition. استنى اترجم. They're shooting live ammunition عشان في امريكان عم بيتفرجوا فبدنا نفهمهم بالانجليزي. انتوا خايفين؟ Are you scared?
Yeah.
You are scared.
Yeah.
طب ليش ما تروح? Why don't you go home? ليش ما تروح على بيتك?
No, no.
ليه؟ احكي عربي. No, no. احكي عربي.
لا بروحش على الضاره.
ليش؟
شو جبتوا علي؟
Oh, they're saying their house is right where the clashes are happening, so they don't want to go home because they can't go home because they're scared.
أنا تصوبت خلاص بطلت أطلع.
كيف تصوبت؟
أكلت مطاطة.
Oh, he's saying he was hit by a rubber. Had that rubber. He was hit by a bullet in the past. And so that's why they don't want to go home. They can't go home right now. فدير بالك, okay?
Yeah.
ديروا بالكم. إحنا أنا من أمريكا.
أهلا وسهلا.
أهلين. مرحبا.
مش لاقي حل في السجن.
ايش
مش لاقي حل بس
طب هذا يعني it's على الانترنت هاي he's like I don't want to end up in jail فاذا ما بدك تبين صورتك امشي فل I told him if you don't want to be shown on camera go so صورتك خلاص they really want to be filmed some of these kids
so
here
there's also some store owner over there but you probably don't want to get out of the car it's so it's if you want to let the audience know it's pouring rain
it is pouring rain guys
yeah.
I turned the camera on me, sorry. Oh, it is okay. Pouring rain. We were outside for, oh, this guy's running. I don't know
yeah,
why.
Yeah, maybe put down the sorry. Window and show people what it
looks Yeah, this is the weather.
It actually calmed the clashes down a little bit because it started raining so hard.
So the interesting thing here is, and even though there's a lot of unrest going on right now, it's almost like life goes on as usual for a lot of these people. Earlier, I was speaking to a young man who was a father, literally with his baby in the street. And I was like, are you scared? He's like, this is normal. These protests are especially, intense on Fridays, which is the day that people have off and the day they go to their prayer. So after prayer is when the protests began. And this has been the case ever since. The local time here is what? It's 2:30 p.m. I would say this has been ongoing since maybe 12:30 or 1. About 45 minutes ago, I think, is when they started firing live ammunition, the Israeli soldiers, and that's when we started to sort of take cover and try to get a safe place. This is the occupied West Bank town of Albira, nearby an Israeli settlement, Sagot. Sagot.
Maybe explain to the audience that's now joining us. Why it is that there's been clashes ongoing on Fridays. The guys you were talking to earlier, if people missed it, were still alive, that they were talking about their reason they're clashing is because of the Al-Aqsa Mosque. Maybe just sort of explain to folks that, well, you can show them outside or something, but let them know
yeah.
what's going on.
So let me just aim the camera outside.
There are?
So basically, guys, there's been a wave of unrest here for the past 2 months. The unrest began in Jerusalem. It was instigated by what Palestinians saw as, I guess, aggressive attempts from the Israeli government to take more of the Al-Aqsa Mosque compound, which the Palestinians say belongs to them, and it is in occupied East Jerusalem. So the epicenter of the latest unrest was Jerusalem. It's then shifted to the occupied West Bank. Now, just for some context here, the West Bank has been under Israeli military occupation since 1967. This is an occupation that controls every single facet of Palestinian life, from movement to economy to where you can... Okay, we're back.
Okay, so
guys, it's pouring, so we're in a car. We think that the confrontation between Palestinian protesters and Israeli soldiers is still ongoing. That's why a lot of people, including us, sought refuge. Prakash, I see that you're asking what's going on there. We're in the occupied West Bank town of Albira, which is close to an Israeli settlement, Sagot. This is the site of unrest and clashes that broke out between Israeli soldiers who responded with live ammunition and rubber-coated steel bullets to Palestinian protesters, mostly young men who were throwing stones and this is where we are. You can still see some people are, these little kids I was speaking to can't go home because their home is where the clashes are and they don't want to get hit. At the same time, they're just kind of out on the street chilling. Shadi's trying to see who we can talk to.
No? Okay, they're saying no.
No. know. Okay.
All right. The guy's here shaking the heads now.
No.
But he's saying that,
wait,
I think we can go up.
Oh, should we go over there?
Okay.
I don't know if we should. I don't want to get wet.
You
don't
know?
I don't
know. I have an umbrella in the trunk.
Here we're live. Oh, sorry. Yeah, Mephisha, broadcast pause. How do you say broadcast pause? Ask them if there's anyone who wants to work on the live stream. So I'm going to point the camera away while I talk to you guys. We're outside trying to see if any of the guys here will talk to us, but I just pointed the camera toward them and they told me to point it away. So Hava is asking to see if anybody wants to be interviewed or not. We're not going to point the camera towards anyone who doesn't want to point it toward them. So nobody wants to? Okay, so we have some...
Go ahead and interview him.
طبعا بصير هون حوار مع الحكاك مع الاحتلال مواجهات احنا اليوم جينا نطالب برساله انه الاقصى مش حاله كل الشعب الفلسطيني مع الاقصى ومنطالب طبعا السلطه الفلسطينيه بوقف التنسيق الامني مع الاحتلال لانه طبعا
I didn't know that. Can we interrupt to translate?
They said that they are here today protesting in front of the Israeli army, and they are here to bring the message that all the Palestinian people is with Al-Aqsa, and to tell the Palestinian Authority to stop the security coordination with Israel. وانت عايش هون؟
إيه لا والله أنا عايش بالخليل فبس كان يعني رام الله.
Okay. He is from Hebron, but he lives in Ramallah.
What is he hoping to achieve? Like, what is he hoping that might happen, or what?
Oh,
that's AJ Plus.
Okay.
Oh, we're back.
Okay. شو أنت بتأمل إنه رح يصير بالمستقبل؟
أنا بتأمل إنه يعني هاي الانتفاضة إن شاء الله باستمرار وإنه مش رح توقف إلا يلبونا مطالبنا اللي هو فتح المعابر وفك الحصار على قطاع غزة وإن شاء الله توصل رسالتنا للاحتلال وإحنا طبعاً بنأكد له إنه الأقصى مش حاله كل الشعب الفلسطيني مع الأقصى ومع المقدسات.
No sound. Okay, can you guys let me know? Are you hearing sound now? Sorry about that. We're having some technical difficulties. Oh, we're back. Dana, we're back. You guys, can you tell me? Hey, you guys who are watching, can you tell me if you see sound or not? Can you please comment and let me know? Okay, we're back. We left off. Hava can tell you where we left off.
Yes, we were.
The sound is back.
Okay, the sound is back. So I don't know where you guys left off, but we're standing a few blocks away from where there have been clashes in the occupied West Bank town of Elvira. I'm just asking them to be quiet so we can actually broadcast. So I guess they were talking to him, and I want to continue to talk to him. Is it Clint Holmes on the web that had put in his car?
He said he wasn't
actually here throwing stones, but he just came in solidarity with those who were. What's your goal?
إحنا هدفنا إنه توصل رسالة لليهود إنه الأقصى مش لحاله، إنه الأقصى كل الشعب الفلسطيني وكل حتى أحيانا العرب مع الأقصى وإن شاء الله رح نحميه لو شو ما كلفنا الثمن رح نحمي الأقصى.
He said that he wants to send a message to the world and to the Israelis that the Aqsa is Palestinian and it's for the Palestinians and they'll do whatever it takes to defend it.
Can he explain for an American audience the significance of Al-Aqsa? Americans don't know.
Okay, so Al-Aqsa Mosque compound in Jerusalem is one of the holiest sites in Islam, but it's also holy to Jews and Israelis. There were recent, I guess, moves on the part of, maybe Hagar can better explain, a couple of months ago. Yeah, so in the last couple of months, more and more Israeli members of parliament started going up to Al-Aqsa and to demand that Jews will be able to pray there as well. and Palestinians see that as a threat to their status quo, which doesn't allow Jews to pray in the
Jews call it Temple Mount, and they say it's also holy to them. But every time that Israelis come with leadership and stuff, it's seen as a big act of provocation. In fact, that is how the second Intifada in the early 2000s was instigated, when Ariel Sharon, the prime minister, then went and visited the mosque. So he is saying that they're trying to send a message to the world and to Israel that the Palestinians will defend that Al-Aqsa Mosque compound, that he's saying Al-Aqsa is for all the Arabs and all the Muslims in the world, and that they want to defend it.
We like the lens. People are complaining. Obviously, it's raining, guys. We can't have the best sound.
I just want to point out, some of these kids earlier were talking.
They don't want to.
Yeah, I know. So we don't want to show them, but some of these kids earlier were talking to me. But they told me not to film them because they don't want their parents to see, number one. Number two, I asked them what you were doing. One of them said, I came to liberate Palestine. So one of the interesting things about this latest wave of unrest is it has very much been led by Palestinian youth, kids their age, and we're not showing them right now. Palestinian kids like this, who I imagine he's like in his, I don't know, 11 or something.
Do you want
like
to tell him to come? No? Okay.
They have been frustrated. A lot of them have a lot of courage because they just feel hopeless, and they have nothing to lose. And so for them, they've grown up knowing nothing but failed negotiations. Of course, the past 20 years have been failed negotiation after negotiation that has delivered nothing for them. All they know is a life under occupation, Israeli military occupation, that restricts every single moment of their life, as well as daily humiliations at checkpoints. So they grow up seeing this, and they grow up seeing clashes like this. And so see if the Chukwu Mu'azzin has to for us. I asked him, do you see clashes or you know, confrontations like this? He said 24 hours they see it. So this is something normal. And just to give you some context here, we're in a residential neighborhood in Albira. People live around here. You know, in the middle of the streets in the neighborhood where they live, there are, you know, there's violence. There's live ammunition being fired, and people are just watching. They're standing and watching. Sadly, this is normal for them.
So can you ask him what sort of, what's the solution that somebody in his generation or that he wants to see? I mean, what's the solution to this? Yeah, the conflict as a whole.
الحل انهم طبعا احنا قدمنا كثير طلبات لليهود انه يصير سلام بيننا وبينهم. طبعا اسرائيل دائما ترفض حل الدولتين, وهي هي صراحه اسرائيل بتحب الحروب وبتحب المعارك وبتحب دائما همها سفك الدماء الفلسطينيه.
He's saying we put forward a lot of requests to Israel for a solution, including a two-state solution, but Israel in his eyes wants war and does not want peace.
A lot of people are complaining about sound, so I'm going to get really close to you guys. I'm doing the best I can. Sorry, guys. So just so you know, our phone, you know, got caught in the pouring rain. Our mic is toast. And so the audio, we're trying to scream as loud as we can, but this is the best we can do. Just bear with us.
Why are you covering your face?
طبعا في هناك جهاز اسمه الشغلات الاسرائيلي بيمارس الاعتقالات ويعني فيش يوم فيش كيف الا تكون اعتقالات, ان كانت بالضفه ان كانت بال 48 او بالقدس, يعني دائما بتمارس علينا الاعتقال. وطبعا عشان في بيكون احيانا جواسيس او شيء دائما مع الاختلاف, عشان بيكون بيكون بعدم التعرف على هويتنا.
Long story short, he says he's basically covering his identity, he's trying to conceal his identity. There's an Israeli, I guess, intelligence unit called Al-Shabak over there that are constantly arresting young Palestinian men like him. He said whether it's here in the West Bank or in or within Israel, and so and there's also informants, he says, so they don't want to be identified because they don't want to be arrested.
I'm gonna just show people what it looks like over there without these guys getting it if they don't want to be in it. So do you want to explain what we're seeing up ahead, Gina, just so people know? There's ambulances up ahead.
Yeah, so we're basically a couple of blocks away from where the clashes broke out. Check out that guy. There's still some press over there and some people with their faces wrapped.
So we're trying to be very careful to not capture people who don't want to be on camera.
Because
so I'm just going to keep it on Dina.
Just telling us they don't want their identity to be known because they're afraid of arrest.
We're back. I have to get really close, sorry.
He's saying, in his opinion, throwing stones is an act of nonviolent resistance, but yet it's enough to get arrested. And so what happens frequently is that Israelis will come and arrest young, even kids, from their homes, and they're actually tried in military courts. I think Israel is one of the only countries that tries children in military courts. So he's saying, we throw stones. He wasn't actually doing it today, but that is an act of nonviolent resistance. But for Israel, that's grounds to arrest you and put you in jail.
Can you ask him why he thinks that throwing rocks is nonviolent?
يعني بجندي مخصص بجميع انواع الاسلحه، مخصص معه كمان انه شيء متطور واسلحه عديده جدا. الحجر شو بيأثر عليه؟ يعني
he's saying compared to the Israelis that have all this weaponry and all these arms, what is a rock?
طبعا مع ذلك اليهود برد علينا بالرصاص الحي، بالمطاط، بكنات، بيطمعونا باشد
القوه. Despite that, the Israelis respond with live ammunition and with rubber coated steel bullets.
Did they see any?
وبيطلق علينا رصاص حي ومطار وبحاولوا يطمعونا قد ما يسعوا له. يعني شيء سلمي، يعني الحجر يعني بنوصل منه رسالة.
He said the same thing, and he's saying that rocks are not non-violent, they're peaceful. ايش هي الرسالة؟
ان هي الرسالة يعني انه الاقصى مش لحاله، واحنا بنحاول نوصل للاحتلال انه يعني احنا بندافع عن الاقصى وانه المقدسات مش لحالها، لانه الاحتلال اتمادى في ممارساته. يعني الكل شاف حركة العائلة الفلسطينية، عائلة الدوابشة في قرية دوما، قضاء نادس، هذه كل هذه العوامل الإرهابية.
So he's saying again that they were trying to send a message to what he calls the occupation. That's how it's referred to here. Sometimes instead of saying Israel, they refer to the whole state as the occupation, that they, you know, that they will protect the Al-Aqsa Mosque. And that he cited the Dawabsha family, a family in the occupied West Bank, that were burned alive by an Israeli settler. And so that is still very much on the minds of the Palestinians here. There was, that included a baby. And the mother and the father died. Where are we? What's this? And this is, okay, here we go. We're back.
Guys, if you've just joined us, we are right now in the occupied West Bank town of Al-Bira. And it's raining right now, and we basically went to our car. We're standing here seeking refuge both from the rain and from the clashes that broke out a couple blocks up over there. You can see there's still ambulance. That was sort of the end of the street, and the clashes were down the street. But what I mean by clashes is that there were Palestinian young men throwing stones at Israeli soldiers. The Israeli soldiers responded with live ammunition as well as rubber-coated steel bullets. That's when we left, and a lot of the press cleared out then because it was not safe. We're talking to some of the young men here. A lot of them don't want their faces shown. They say because there are Israeli intelligence units up there that will come and arrest them later. I was just talking to a young man here who's here in solidarity and with the Palestinians. He wasn't actually throwing stones, but he was telling me in his opinion that when young Palestinian men throw stones, that is not an act of violence, that is a peaceful means of resistance. And he says, we asked him, why is it peaceful you're throwing stones? He said, compared to the sophisticated weaponry that the Israeli army has, what is a stone? So that's where we are right now. Just for some context, Al-Bira, I don't know if you can see the settlement over here. Shadi, come with me. Okay guys, as I was saying, we're in the occupied West Bank town of Al-Bira, where unrest basically broke out. I'm going to try to get out of the rain after Friday prayers here. Just to situate you, we are in Al-Bira. It is a Palestinian town. And just up the hill right now, which you can't really see because it became foggy. Oh, thanks for the umbrella, Shadi. Just up the hill is an Israeli settlement called Sagot. It is one of two Israeli settlements that overlooks the Ramallah area. I don't know. I think you'll slip. It's wet. Sagot is one of two Israeli settlements that overlook this area. The other one is Beit Il, where clashes normally break out. So they are really literally overlooked by a settlement. These settlements are in violation of international law. That is the consensus of the international community. It means that Jews are able to live there right next to Palestinians. Oh, thank you. Israel disputes that, of course. His name is Jacob, Yaakov. What are you doing here? He says, I want to go up and liberate Tahrir Palestine. He wants to go liberate Palestine. What do you mean from the Jews, he said, which to me, I think he means the Israelis.
Dina, it's back on. Okay, I'm gonna
camera. Dina's talking to someone who just called to make sure that we're all fine. And so we're taking some refuge here. Me and Hakou. So I'll just reiterate what we're doing here, and I'm pointing it toward myself just because there's a lot of young men here who don't want to be filmed, so I'm trying to respect that. So we are a couple of blocks away, but it looks like it's moving closer. Oh, people are running.
Okay, we should get in the park. Get in. We gotta get in. Get in the park. Get in the park. Hagar, get in the park. Where's Hagar? Hagar, she's in the store.
We'll go get her.
Okay, go this way. Where the fuck did she go?
وين البنت اللي كانت معانا؟ وينها؟
She went this way.
Yeah.
Okay, you guys, so we...
Let's go interview somebody.
So we ran into the car. Watch out, watch out. We ran into the car because...
Unrest has moved down this way, so they told us to go away. So our colleague is in this store over here.
Let me film her.
No,
you want me to go in with her? Okay.
I'll hold it for you.
All right.
Get out of the car.
I left my umbrella back there, and I swore on live stream. Okay, guys, we're getting out of the car again, and we're going to go into a store where Hagar is interviewing some folks because the clashes were moving pretty close to us. So I'm going to pass it back to...
So I think the screen is a little bit wet. Let me just fix it.
Thank
you. So Shadi was saying we saw a bunch of young men running down the street, and we took the cue to get away in case anything happened.
It seems the clashes are moving closer to...
So this guy, his name is Akram. He owns the store right here. So I just want to... Arabic. Okay, so we'll talk to him in Arabic. I just want to get a sense of... He's saying, okay, his mom is over there, and she's working here as well. So we just want to ask you guys, I mean, it's an outsider, it seems very weird that in the middle of a Palestinian residential community, there's clashes like this breaking out, there's live ammunition being fired by the Israeli soldiers.
Okay, we're back live.
We're back. So Akram here is the owner of this store. And as I was saying before, we were interrupted. To an outsider, it's really bizarre that these kind of things break out in the middle of a residential community. But one of the facts of life here is that life goes on. So بالنسبة إلك هل هذا إشي يعني غريب إنه تصير مواجهات هيك برا محله؟
طبعا
لا. It's not weird. He's like, of course it's not. ليش؟
طبعا إحنا ولدنا بهاي الظروف يعني وتعودنا على هاي الظروف يعني.
He's saying we were born in these type of conditions and we're used to these type of conditions.
يعني نحنا يعني دولة.
Tina, get this on while he's talking.
تحت غطرة الاحتلال.
He's saying we're a community that lives under the.
We'll take it after because we're back live. So okay. You guys are gonna get a little. So this is we're getting juice given to us by his mother who owns the store. You can see some young men who are coming in for refuge here, and you're also about to see me and Hagar will dip in the corner. But you're gonna see a little bit of behind the scenes of Dina filming an interview. With this man who's inside the store, and we'll have a piece coming out later, so stay tuned for that. So Daryl's just getting set up. Until Daryl gives us the cue, Dina can control. And this is a store that's a few blocks away. There's clashes right behind me. There's people. We're live again. So everybody, we are live as you saw from... I'm going to turn the camera
so you guys can see
us. Okay. So we're live right
now. This is Hagar. Yeah, let me just sign us out. So we're live right now from the scene of clashes in the West Bank. There was, thank you. There was
men that were tossing rocks at Israeli soldiers, and there were soldiers who we heard were firing live ammo. There was all kinds of clashes happening. Now we're a couple of blocks away from it, taking some refuge along with all the other.